Sprinkler irrigation. The irrigation method of sprinkler is a modern and widespread method due to its high efficiency. It spreads the moisture distribution on the surface and inside the soil and provides the necessary materials for its installation. Sprinkler irrigation is a type of irrigation system used in fields and farms, especially in desert areas and sandy soils, in which different and various water sprinklers are used, depending on the method of spraying, the method of work, or by the extent of spraying. The efficiency of sprinkler irrigation systems ranges from 50% to 70%. In this way, the water is added above the surface of the earth as a rain-like mist, as a result of its exit from narrow holes under a certain pressure that is sufficient to reach the soil in the root zone to its field capacity with the least amount of water losses. General advantages of the sprinkler irrigation method. 1. Used for irrigation of land with a steep slope or irregular surface. 2. It is used for the irrigation of high permeable lands. 3. Suitable for soil with heterogeneous cross-section, reducing soil erosion and maintaining surface fertility. 4. Suitable for lands with high groundwater level. 5. The possibility of adding fertilizers and pesticides through the sprinkler irrigation network. 6. It is used to irrigate rough terrain whose terrain does not allow leveling. 7. Providing manpower and not requiring workers with high technical experience. 8. It can be used to protect crops from frost. 9. It can be used to irrigate most crops. The planning of sprinkler irrigation systems is the determination of the position of the components of the sprinkler irrigation system on the land to be irrigated. That is, determining the location of the pump according to the water source, the mainline and the sublines according to the earth's inclination. In order for the irrigation engineer to plan the sprinkler irrigation network, first, it is necessary to identify the different sprinkler irrigation methods and the components that will be used to plan and calculate this network. Sprinkler irrigation is divided into two main types. 1. Traditional sprinkler irrigation systems. Traditional sprinkler irrigation systems are one of the first types of sprinkler irrigation systems and are still the most used systems to date. Conventional systems use rotating sprinklers with operating pressures that range from 2 to 4 bar, and the rate of addition in them ranges from 5 to 35 millimeters an hour. This type of sprinkler irrigation is characterized by the presence of sprinklers of different technology that rotate and require high pressure. The advantages of this method. The economy of irrigation water compared to other methods. Total utilization of the land area. Irrigation of rough terrain. Homogeneous water distribution. Negatives. Need practical experience in this for homogeneity of distribution. Need construction costs. Needing permanent and costly maintenance. It does not work in areas with high winds. Traditional sprinkler irrigation systems are divided into a movable irrigation system. The sub-main pipes and the pump in this system are mobile from one place to another according to the need for irrigation. These systems are characterized by their relatively low initial cost, but the most important disadvantages are the high operating cost and need a lot of labor. In this way, the subline is usually moved from one place to another until the irrigation of the area has been completed. Then these pipes with the main tubes and the pump are transferred to another location or field to irrigate the second area. Thus the system transfer process continues until the irrigation of the entire field is complete. B. Semi-movable irrigation system, The subpipes in the system are mobile, while the main pipes and the pump are fixed, and usually the pipes are buried under the soil surface, and it is preferable that the main tube be in the middle of the field as much as possible so that the irrigation of the field is ensured consistently. See fixed irrigation system, all parts such as mains pipes, pumps, and sprinklers are installed in the system. It is possible to irrigate large areas with this system and dispense with a lot of manpower. 2. Automated or moving sprinkler irrigation systems. This method is very developed and modern in use and used in large agricultural lands. Disadvantages. Very expensive. Need the experience to deal with. Requires high pressure to operate. Its advantages. Improving crop quality. Use them in different types of lands. Water uniformity with high efficiency and quantity control. Moving sprinkler irrigation systems are divided into A. Center pivot system. This system consists of a sprinkler tube mounted on towers equipped with wheels through which the sprinkler tube rotates around a central axis, and the sprinkler tube is equipped with water from the axle tube with a high-capacity pump. The distance between the towers ranges between 24 and 76 meters. The kinetic energy source of the device are small electric motors installed at the wheels of each tower, and the length of the spray tube in general ranges between 365 and 400 meters. The axial system consists of a pipeline that contains sprinklers and fixed from one end. The fixed end is called the access point and the free end is called the end. The access point is a concrete base on which the access has installed this tube, which is called the sprinkler line from the ground with a distance of up to 3 meters. This line is carried off the ground by several pillars called towers and by metal wires or hackers. Each tower is away from the other on the length of the line with a distance ranging from 25 to 75 meters depends on the length of the axial spray line where it decreases when the line lengthens until the towers bear the resulting weight of increasing the length and this distance between the towers increases when the length of the line decreases and these towers are installed on wheels or skis, the lengths of pipes or bridges between 50 to 800 meters, but the length used is about 400 meters, and the diameter used for pipes ranges from 142 to 168 millimeters. The system is supplied with water by a tube that extends across the field below the surface of the earth if the water source is outside the field, or from a well near the axis and then to the sprinkler line via the axis, then to the sprinklers during irrigation when the system is running. When the system is running, the sprinkler line constantly rotates around the axis without stopping to water circular area that may reach 100 hectares. The wheels of the towers are managed by a small electric motor with a capacity ranging from 0.5 to 1.5 horses installed on each tower to manage the two wheels on which the tower is mounted. In the case of devices that are electrically managed and are the most widespread, and gets electrical energy from a generator at the axis powered by an internal combustion machine, or from the public electricity network via buried underground connections to the hub. Most axial irrigation systems operate with a voltage ranging between 380 to 480 volts, three-way current, and a frequency of 60 Hz, while the system control dockers usually operate at 110 volts. Another way for moving towers such as hydraulics. Mounting devices are installed on the towers to control the movement of each tower along the axial line in order to keep the line in one straightness starting from the axis point to the last tower, and the last tower controls the speed of rotation of the system as the movement starts from it. The straightening of the pipe is carried out by the towers that take its tracks freely in relation to the last tower, the axis of the device, and in the event of a malfunction in the integrity of the system, the device stops moving itself because there are devices equipped with it to completely stop the system in the event of a malfunction. Install on the sprinkler line either fixed or rotating sprinklers, and the distances between these sprinklers are either equal or variable, or the sprinkler sizes change with equal distances between them so that an increasing spray rate can be obtained whenever we move away from the axis and we find that the sprinklers are arranged on the axis with specific numbers, and this arrangement is very important and should not be changed when maintaining or replacing the sprinklers, as this affects the distribution of water over the crop. The spray rate ranges from 5 to 75 mm/hour along the line for rotating sprinklers, while the spray rate increases when using stationary spray to about 300 mm/hour at the far end of the axis. B. Lateral move system. In addition to center pivot system, the lateral move systems have developed that can irrigate virtually 100% of rectangular or square fields made of high-strength steel. Laterals are available as canal feed and hose drag systems, and with a four-wheel or two-wheel power tower, the four-wheel drive tower provides the maximum pulling power necessary for large fields. The unit's floating axles keep all four tires on the ground, giving it the traction to pull the large hoses required by high-flow systems for the ultimate and lateral versatility offers the pivoting lateral move system. After traveling down one side of the field, the system can pivot 180 degrees and return up the other side, allowing you to irrigate twice as many acres with half the equipment. Versatile and efficient, all laterals can be equipped with a self-contained engine, and generator guidance options for lateral move systems include cable furrow and fence line guidance, along with buried wire and navigator GPS guidance. The water is fed to the irrigation system using a water channel or using a flexible hose connected to the machine. The length can be supplied in this type of sprinkler irrigation from one bridge to seven bridges, and the length of the bridge may reach 800 meters. If the irrigation system is designed with two wings, and if the machine is made to walk 2,000 meters, then the total irrigation area can be 160 hectares. C. Artillery sprinkler system. It is an irrigation system equipped with a large high-capacity sprinkler installed on a cart and connected to a hose that transports water from the source. The cart is drawn along the field either with a wire or with the water hose itself, and the reel is managed either by water pressure or by an internal combustion machine, and this system needs a compressor to operate its amount not less than 55 meters. One of the advantages of this system is the ease and speed of its transportation from one location to another, which helps to water several fields in one season. The diameter of the tube ranges between 75 and 130 millimeters, its length may reach 400 meters, and with discharge ranging between 6 to 13 L/s and watering a field of length 800 meters. Moving artillery spray systems use large rotating sprinklers and at high operating pressure to irrigate large areas, and spray rates range between 535 mm/hour. There are two types of these systems. One, hose pull system. The hose pull system device has a spray gun installed on a wheeled vehicle, and the water is connected to the device via a flexible hose up to 200 meters in length, and the diameter ranges between 50-100 millimeters, and it can be pulled behind the device, and when planning the hose pull system, the main water pipe is placed. It connects the pumping station and the field through the center of the field, and its slice of land up to 400 meters in length can be irrigated in one position, although the length of the hose does not exceed 200 meters. The spray rate can be controlled by the pressure of the available water at the spray gun, and the speed of the device's vehicle will control the depth of the added irrigation water, and the speeds of such devices range from 10 to 50 meters/hour. 2. Hose, reel system. In this system, the artillery spray device is installed on a wheeled vehicle and the water is connected to the device by a hose that is more durable compared to that used in the hose pull system, but it is flexible enough to be able to wrap it on a large roller and uses the hose to pull the artillery spray device towards the reel placed at the end of the solution, and there are devices available with hoses ranging in length from 200-400 meters. When planning to such a system, the main water pipe depends on the pumping station across the middle of the field.